Hi, I'm Jim McCord, Product Marketing Engineer at Keysight Technologies. This is one in a series of LTE-Advanced carrier aggregation demonstrations using Keysight's UXM wireless test set. For this demo, our applications engineer, Kenneth Clark, is here to show you the downlink channel configuration flexibility for LTE receiver testing. He'll also show you the impact of these configurations on throughput. For this demo, Kenneth will be using a commercially available LTE-Advanced Category 4 device. Over to you, Kenneth.
Thanks, Jim. LTE networks are designed to be able to adapt to a wide range of real-world operating conditions. Depending upon the quality of the downlink channel, the eNode B will adjust the modulation type, coding schemes, and resource block allocations to optimize for the best performance. This results in thousands of potential scenarios under which the mobile device may need to perform. Making sure your device can deal with all these combinations is no easy task, and that's why we developed the UXM with the most flexible and easy-to-use LTE downlink channel configuration in the industry. Let's start that demonstration with the UXM's blur versus time measurement. This Cat4 device achieves 145 megabits per second downlink and 25 megabits per second uplink. Let's view the standard RMC configuration, and I'll show you how you can easily configure the downlink channel. By selecting this parameter, I am able to set the modulation schemes for all the subframes in a code word at once. I'll drop the modulation coding scheme from 28 to 24 for both code words. You can see the throughput drop on the measurement trace as expected. Now I'll modify only one code word. For all the subframes, I'll select 18 and apply that to code word 2. Again, there's a further drop in throughput as expected. For even more flexibility, you can disable Configure All Subframes at Once and set the modulation coding scheme for each subframe individually and for each code word. As you modify these settings, you can also view the data throughput on the fly. Now that we've seen the flexibility in setting modulation coding schemes, let's look at the resource block allocations. This interface provides the configuration options to allocate consecutive subframes or all the subframes at once, and also non-contiguous allocations. I will reduce the number of resource blocks by arbitrarily selecting just a few. Again, throughput has dropped as expected because of the reduced allocation. As you can see, with this large touch interface, it's very simple to configure different scenarios. Back to you, Jim.
Thanks, Kenneth. We just saw the extreme flexibility the UXM provides in LTE downlink channel configuration and resource block allocations. This enables you to quickly and easily validate device performance under a wide range of operating conditions. With the UXM, you can assess your design readiness with greater confidence. Is your design ready? For more information, visit the website on your screen. Thanks for watching.